Today we're going to talk about Interim Tier 4, or IT4, engine emission control. There are more than a few differences in IT4 engines, so there will be many guidelines and numbers to remember. Please refer to your operator's manual for the specific information that we will be discussing. The emission control is mandated by the EPA and affects 75 horsepower and above engines. The IT4 mandate requires changes to the engine on the fuel intake side and on the exhaust outlet side. On the fuel intake side, there's a high-pressure common rail fuel distribution system. There's also a new fuel filter with a water separator, crankcase breather filter, fuel cooler, and supply pump. The fuel system on the engine requires special tools and knowledge to troubleshoot and repair. See your Bobcat dealer for a qualified technician with the proper training and tools to keep your engine and emission systems operating properly. It's very important to use high-quality, ultra-low sulfur fuel with IT4 engines. The sulfur content should be less than 15 parts per million. Biodiesel can be used, but only up to a 5% ratio. Check the operator's manual and follow the specific guidelines for biodiesel. The engine oil must meet API CJ4 standards, which reduces ash buildup in the diesel particulate filter, or DPF. On the exhaust side of the engine, there is a diesel particulate filter, which is used to trap and collect soot. The DPF will heat up internally in the canister when the machine is being worked steadily, and the soot will be burned off from the system. This process of collecting and burning the soot is called regeneration. There are four types of regeneration. Passive, when the engine exhaust is at adequate temperature. Active, where the engine control unit, or ECU, controls the process of generating enough heat in the DPF to burn the soot. Parked, when the operator initiates regeneration using the optional remote parked regeneration kit. And service, when the Bobcat dealer uses specialized equipment to perform a service regeneration. Passive regeneration is the most common, and it occurs when the engine is operating at a load that can provide a high enough exhaust temperature in the DPF so regeneration occurs naturally. Active regeneration is controlled by the ECU by injecting fuel into the DPF to raise the temperature at approximately 40 to 60 hour intervals. When this is happening, you'll hear one beep and the D-rate override switch will illuminate. You won't need to stop working or shut down the machine. It's just a reminder that regeneration is occurring. If the ECU cannot complete the regeneration or the DPF remains restricted, a level 2 active regeneration cycle will begin. You'll hear a 2-beep alarm, the D-rate override switch will flash, and the engine will derate by 25%. Pushing the top of the switch will override the engine derate and the light will stop flashing and remain on. But if you choose to override this process, the machine should be operated above half throttle and under a load that will facilitate regeneration, or soot will build up in the DPF. The derate override switch will flash every 10 minutes if the load is not sufficient. You should continue to operate until a level 2 regeneration is completed. If all goes well, the switch will return to the normal position and the light will turn off once the regeneration is finished. In certain applications, you may not want regeneration occurring, so there's an optional kit available. It contains a DPF inhibit switch that replaces the D-rate override switch. After it's been installed, simply press the bottom of the switch to activate it. When DPF regeneration is being inhibited, the switch will light up. Service codes M8551 and M8552 will appear and will continue to prevent regeneration until the machine is turned off. Automatic regeneration will return the next time the machine is turned on. But remember, inhibiting regeneration will cause continued soot to build up in the DPF, so it's important to allow regular regeneration to occur to help maintain a longer service life of the DPF. Service codes M8551 and M8552 will occur when the DPF system is inhibited from automatically performing an active regeneration. You can also inhibit the machine from reverting back to automatic the next time it turns on by holding the bottom of the DPF inhibit switch for 4 seconds. The operator can re-enable the regeneration to occur by pressing the top of the DPF inhibit switch. In the inhibit mode, the same two active service codes will occur, stopping it from automatically performing an active regeneration. But if too much soot is allowed to accumulate, because of the short periods of operation, or the DPF inhibit switch is left in the inhibit position too long, a level 3 remote regeneration may be necessary. Service codes M8551 and M8552 will occur when the DPF system is inhibited from automatically performing an active regeneration. When this happens, a two-beep alarm will sound, the DPF DEF icon will be flashing, the inhibit switch will be on, the engine will derate by 25%, and the code M8553 will be on the display. At this stage, you can use the parked regeneration kit to initiate a regeneration while outside the operator compartment. To perform it, be sure there's enough fuel for 1 hour of operation. When using the remote regeneration kit, safety precautions have been put in place, such as locking out the operator controls in the cab and applying the parking brake so it is safe for the engine to run without an operator in the seat. After it's performed the remote regeneration, the machine will shut down automatically. However, you must turn off the remote key before the machine can be operated normally. If you've continued to operate the machine without regeneration happening, an alert to the next level will occur. A two-beep alarm will sound, the DPF-DEF icon will be flashing, the switch will be flashing, the engine will derate to 50%, and an M8554 service code will appear. At this point, a dealer with special tools must be called to perform a service regeneration. The final level of monitoring is for DPF cleaning. If this is required, a two-beep alarm will sound, the DPF-DEF icon will be flashing, and the general warning icon will be flashing. An M8555 service code will be visible. At this point, the DPF will need to be removed by a trained Bobcat service technician and taken to a cleaning station to have the ash removed. As a general rule, make sure regular regeneration is taking place so the DPF does not become plugged and have to be removed and cleaned. Operating under normal conditions with regeneration occurring as necessary, you can get over 3,000 hours of use before the regular removal maintenance needs to be performed on the DPF. Bobcat loaders equipped with the iT4 engines are another example of Bobcat Company building products to meet the needs of our environment and our customers in the marketplace. If you need or want more information, contact your local Bobcat dealer. They can also offer training or perform service work for your Bobcat machine and are your source for genuine Bobcat parts.